to feel and speak the astonishing beauty of things. Earth, stone and water, beast, man and woman, sun, moon and stars, the bloodshot beauty of human nature, its thoughts, frenzies and passions, and unhuman nature, its towering reality. For man's half dream, man, you might say, is nature dreaming, but rock and water and sky are constant. To feel greatly and understand greatly and express greatly the natural beauty is the sole business of poetry. The rest's diversion. Those holy or noble sentiments, the intricate ideas, the love, lust, longing, reasons, but not the reason.